And here we go, and wow, this UI is huge. It was not supposed to be that big. You know when you have, you know, the Windows scaling wrong bug? Yeah, that's what we got right here on the screen share. So let's just update the votes. Oh, God damn it, did I not copy it previously? Let me just do that as the map bans, or the operator bans rather, are underway. If you guys want to vote, you have exclamation mark vote. Right now it's not going to be displayed on the screen since we are no longer displaying it. You know, we're in the game menu now, but you can still see what the community thinks. Operator bans. What are we saying so far? Nomad, that's not something I would have expected, but you know, we talked about the roamers being somewhat important, so it does make sense, though we didn't predict it.
Yeah, we definitely didn't predict it, but I do have to agree with you that Nomad is still a very solid ban here alongside Habana. That mean that Blackbeard is still 100% going to be in play alongside Thatcher, but Habana has so much power on this map because getting to any real reinforced site walls is such a tricky situation, leaves you open and vulnerable to so many angles. A Habana is going to mean a world of hurt for any defending team, given that the player knows how to use Habana, right? Jaeger, a ban as well. Something I don't think we were expecting as much, but with the recent Ying buff, I would imagine that getting rid of those ADSs is going to be huge for anyone who's on the attacking side first.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's kind of surprising, I have to say, since, you know, Buck just lost the frag grenades, you'd be expecting to go in against a fewer amount of frag grenades. Sorry for those hiccups. But what I do believe might be happening right here is simply the fact that Ying is being played heavily, is being played a lot now. And as such, you know, you want to be making sure that her blanket counter is no longer in play. Wumai might still be picked. So if you don't pay attention, you know, there's still a way of countering those, you know, Candela charges. But so far, for the very first round, he is going to be making an appearance, but Ying isn't. So make of that what you will.
I know we saw someone pick Ying and then switch off of her before this phase began. So I think we can see a six pick. And yes, that's exactly where it is. And while Omai is still useful here, it's not going to be as useful because it doesn't completely deny the Candela charge like Jaeger's ATSs would. Instead, his magnet just moves it to a different location and continues to detonate it. Just, you know, same old, just it didn't roll into sight. It just flew into the corner or something like that. Which could still be very negative to anyone who would be sitting in a corner, like maybe a very hard anchor such as Echo.
Especially since the Candela charge is basically a cluster charge, right? So as such, the explosive radius, or the flash radius rather in that instance, is so much greater than a regular flash grenade, frag grenade, smoke grenade, all that good stuff. So moving it rather than flat out absorbing it might not be as, you know, good for those gadgets than it would be on any other, you know? But that's basically going to be what I had to say. I do see the players in chat saying you can't run Valkalite. I am not sure why they do say that, but the rules say nothing of such. So there you go. I'm kind of getting distracted by details, and I'm aware of that. But as an admin, as a referee, on top of being a caster, I kind of have to keep an eye on those details. So sorry if the actual, you know, presentation casting suffered from that. Kind of have to.
Vital first pick here as well. Coming out from Nisha, taking out Buck, the main stop structure. And is this going to be just a full on push and plant in 30 seconds into the lane?
Seems to be. He's tossing a natural cell, isn't he? Yeah, but that's going to be team kill, unfortunate. Diffuser already planted. What round is that? Lion is hiding, is hankering behind that bomb. And there you go. Nice, easy kill. The problem is, Gecko is now last operator alive, and he does not have too great of a firepower. So he will have to do try his best, but it's only the matter of tossing the natural cell the right way, and he's done for. And there you go, that run out from the side entrance is gonna win it. We get first rounded, really went all in, you know. But you know, they bet on the wrong horse there, definitely.
We got to see practically nothing of the true power a RT Kitchen defense could have because of just a pure rush straight in the kitchen that I don't think anyone really expected, albeit being first round. You know, you can you have a little time to, you know, play around, get back into the swing of things. This is Wii Get First Round, its first game on for this tournament, or the finals for the time being, as opposed to RT, who's already kind of warmed up, kind of has, you know, landed their shots onto the previous match. So I guess they could just kind of be going for a Hail Mary, but there could be a lot of potential comeback from here, from Wii Get First Rounded, considering the fact that they were even able to get the plant down. And someone from RT, I don't remember exactly who it was whoever was playing Bandit, Ness, I believe, actually throwing the Nitro Cell and team killing. That was
unfortunate. Attackers need to locate here's the thing, you kind of have to think, we get first round, really, I don't want to say through that round, but they did not try hard there. They kind of went for a troll rush blind, let's just try it and see what happens. It didn't work out, but if they do end up considering RT to be, you know, a worthy opponent, if they are to, you know, try to play it seriously, I would be interested to see how that situation would play out, you know?
Yeah, I 100% agree. And I'm kind of wondering if we'll see the same thing here. The lack of a line coming up from Wii Get First Round, I don't imagine it'd be as much of an aggressive push, but between Ash, IQ, a couple of three speeds, and then Capitao, Zofia, and Yang, that's plenty of, you know, different utility that could stop anyone from knowing that they're planting. Between Zofia's stuns and the Yang flash grenades, there's a lot of sound loss. Even if you're not directly looking at the planter, there's a lot of sound loss there.
Yeah.
And you won't be able to tell.
Yeah, and you know, that's another blind rush, which apparently was gonna get cut off really early. Not getting the kill though, and Firemeister on the outside is gonna cut off that rotation. He's not in Billiard's room. Had he had the diffuser, he could be planting 10 times now, but he will be cut off. He went in for blind kills, and that did not work out too well because he didn't know where his opponents were going to be. Let's see what the rest of the team are going to try to do, because this time, you know, it is going to be a bit more tactical, a bit more methodical. Psycho being the bearer of the diffuser, let's see what he goes for, because, you know, everybody else, whatever they're doing, is going to be either a distraction or covering him. So there you go. That's Snaze, a new gamer tag in that team name. Sorry about that. Yeah, he was able to cover. He's going to get bested. CDD Ash apparently was not able to prevent the plant of the diffuser, and he seems to be expecting somebody to be at the window. Here we go. He's not going to get the kill, though. Firemeister still going strong, though he's taking a bit of damage. He now knows where his opponent is going to be, and, you know, losing that much health in order to get intel might be even a trade that's worth it.
The amount of health loss was definitely nothing compared to how low Dash was. And now left in a tight 1v2 situation here, AIDS doesn't have much to take on as they just rush in and really obliterate him from trying to deny any sort of bomb going off, trying to get that defuse off. But unfortunately, it just didn't work out for him. And we get first round is going to go ahead and take their first round now using a very similar, almost the exact same rush plant strategy with all smokes, all of the Ying's flash grenades needed to get that down.
I'm not exactly sure what AIDS was trying to achieve, you know, because by tossing the magnet at the very, because, you know, he was in the 1v2 situation, that was still doable for him if he played it right. As such, throwing the magnet in the attacker's line of sight, they could easily reverse engineer, you know, the or where that throw originated from, and the magnet was not going to block bullets. So there you go. Gecko really had the easiest kill ever in that situation, and I'm not sure why, once again, Age just gave them a free opportunity like he did.
Especially with such a powerful weapon such as the AUG in his hands, I would have imagined a much more kind of less aggressive push. It's still gonna be aggressive because, you know, we are coming down to the last 15 seconds of that defuse timer, but he still had so much potential with the AUG being what I would argue as probably one of the headshot machines of defense with its slow fire rate and high power with low recoil. Well, mine has a lot of potential in that sense, but with so few magnets down, he couldn't risk getting flashed, getting smoked, getting stunned even once, because that would have been even more of a game over, even worse than it was before.
Indeed. So, with all that being said, let's just take a look at the third round here, because RT, since they lost, they had the choice to go here again, and they're going to do so. This time, kind of adapting their strategy. They really do know what we get first round tend to do. They are trying to, you know, prevent a blind rush strat to work once again. Goyo, Smoke, Echo, and Legion are all four of them far out of the five operators, and you might even argue AIDS to cut off those Candela charges, basically to make sure the blind rush is not going to work. but they're kind of all playing the counter to a single playstyle, and this time WeGet First Round are not rushing, so our team might be ill-equipped to face against WeGet First Round's current composition.
Doesn't even be that way. Some fair shots right now on both sides, with the, and I would not argue equal utility by any means. Aids can take, gets taken out as well, and that is even less utility on board for RT for the rest of this round, as there is already a lot of control inside of luggage, inside of the Aqua. There is a lot of ground left to cover.
Oh, he didn't get a lot of shots
coming out from both sides. Very unfortunate he didn't get that kill. Dash doing a lot of damage to Psycho. Definitely be able to fix it, but with the fire grenades that Maverick has recently gotten in the past couple months, he's going to be able to take out that Goyo shield in just a few seconds. I think that we can see another potential rush with Snazzy, the gang still on board.
And here I go, utility slowly being used up, so the shield was the attackers doing, but the smoke canisters being tossed really in order to try to prevent the attackers from blindly rushing in. He's gonna get flashed, but that doesn't really matter since he still has his yokai drones. The only one who still has a, you know, a partial sight is gonna be Juan. He's not in a position to prevent the defuser from being planted. That is not gonna work. That was close, but too little too late. So now we're gonna be finding ourselves in a retake situation. Two defenders, now attackers basically, are going for the face check, whereas C-Dash was, I believe, going for a rotation, but it's gonna be B-Shash who does it. Not even. They go for the corridor and kind of decide against that. So it's gonna be face checks, basically. Psycho getting a first kill, another decal, a decal strafe. Wow, that was a French term. Yeah, another strafe, and there we go, Gecko getting a nice double kill.
It does not seem that WeGet First Rounded is letting up on their strategy at all. While it still seemed that there was going to be a little more, you know, a little more apprehensive pushing here coming from WeGet First Rounded, we still saw Snazzy throwing in all those candelas to go for the rush plant. And Dash was just a very, like, milliseconds too late to actually landing that yokai's shot to try to disorient him. While it would have been perfect timing, would have been perfect location, it was just very, very milliseconds, very few milliseconds made the difference between how long that round was going to go. Albeit there probably wasn't another yokai in the greatest position to try to deny it again.
It had to be somewhat hidden though, because if not, yeah, it would have been an easy prey. But I totally do get what you mean.
Especially with a Thatcher in the works here, a Thatcher's EMP, I should say, straight into the objective could have disabled one of those yokais, and that would have been an easy pick there.
Yeah.
Actually, no, I don't think we saw Thatcher last round. But regardless, smoke grenades, yokais can't see smoke through smoke grenades like Maestro's Evil Eyes can. So yeah, there's just not a lot of real ability to know where they're planting unless you're shooting blind into default.
So yeah, especially considering that Thatcher is not banned, I am quite surprised that he's not being played too much. But, you know, that would open up the possibility to a discussion here. Ying, looking at this game right here, in a bubble, outside of, well, you know, whatever else might be happening in Pro League or at any other level of play, Ying might be seeming OP right now. You know, you ban Jaeger, and it is really easy to open up or to just eat away at the magnets by using a few smoke grenades, flash grenades, and then you toss in the candela charges. Right now, I don't see what RT could be doing to counter Hawks's candela charges. Like, really, there doesn't seem to be a counter to that playstyle. And to me, that would be the exact definition of OP.
I 100% agree, and I feel like the number one thing that is being forced at hand here, or is being attempted to be forced at hand, with Ying becoming so overpowered, especially with the Jaeger ban, would be a possible play for Warden. This would be a very prime time for him to be used, but there's still plenty of people watching as well. If Hawks, or whoever's playing Ying, is the one getting the Fuser down, although he is the one getting the kill onto AIDS, if he's not the one getting the Fuser down, he can see right through that Candelas, and that plant is going to be, denial attempt is going to be all for naught here.
Absolutely. So you're right. I had not thought of Warden one second, and you know, it would be the logical answer here, because that's the very definition of his gadget. And I do believe there's Ace, so let's still AFK in the spawn. So that would be a 4v5 situation at the beginning of the round. But even being a man down, figuratively speaking, WeGet First Round are not going to be impressed by that. They are still funneling in, getting the kills. Diffuser is now actively being planted. Snaze is getting a kill on Bisha. Last operator alive was going to be Echo. He did nothing. And there we go. Snaze coming in, getting a double kill. You don't even have to plant the diffuser.
That was an absolutely brutal round, to say the least. And I think that's something that we've seen literally every single round up until now. Now, unfortunately for we get first rounded, there was one of Goyo's Vulcans in the direct line of sight for pure denial purposes on that kitchen window. But we get first round, didn't even need to worry about RT's Goyo shield or Vulcan shield, because they just went full on for a service entrance push. And with Goyo now only having two Vulcans, he's not able to cover enough ground and not able to risk enough of his utility to try to deny both plants when that fire is going to be gone in just a few seconds. With we get first round of running both Ash and Sophia, there's plenty of impact grenades. Regardless of how many magnets there are still plenty of different ways to get rid of those Vulcans.
So here would be just brainstorming possible counters to the overpowered Ying that we're seeing currently, assuming, you know, Jaeger is being banned. If you are to roam a bit more heavily, basically spreading your defenders out, making it so that a Candela charge cannot, you know, incapacitate three defenders at the same time. Or, you know, if a particular defender is being too difficult to flush out, well, if you are to use your Candela charges against him, you're not going to have him to push into the bombsite later on, you know? Might that work? Possibly, depending on the bombsite. Like you said, the side entrance push, roamers cannot do anything against that. So I'm kind of passing the question off to you. Would that be a possibility here? Just, you know, brainstorming, generally speaking.
I imagine it would be a possibility, but with the pure aggression that we get first round is bringing here, I don't think so. And no, we are seeing some aggression fired back here from AIDS, taking out Psycho right off the bat. Definitely not the Ying, but the Maverick is still a very big character and very big player here, as Firemeister is going to go ahead and finish off AIDS here, left on very little health, however, and is now going to be the number one pushing objective. Bisha is also far off site, all the way down blue bar, and is going to take out Firemeister. That has two of the very kind of the rushing operators trying to push in, and we see Hawks doing the exact same thing once again. Oh, but he's aware of the Nitro Cell. Bisha is going to go ahead and deny that plant. Defuser is still down in sight, but however, it's not planted. Now 2v2, Bisha's off site. And one is the only one left on site.
Yeah, but he still has a good position. Like, with that current line of sight, he can cut off both attackers at the same time. He's gonna take a bit of damage, not inflicting too much in return. The fuser's now being planted, so everything might be down on Bisha's flank. He will not get the kill, unfortunately. I thought he was gonna get that one, getting a frag in return, and that was the frag on the barrel of the diffuser. Diffuser now not being planted, and if Snaze wants to do that, he's alone. So he would be making himself, and as such, every remaining attacker vulnerable. Juan will have to jump on the opportunity, though, and he's too far out to do so. So it's gonna be down to a 1v1 situation, and that wallbang from Snaze! I don't know if that was pure, you know, instinct, callouts, a drone, something, but he knew what to expect.
I feel like that was almost just a straight-up pre-fire, but from what it seems like, we get first rounded is having fabulous drone work here, so I would expect it to be a drone, definitely, per se. And
probably, yeah.
That's only because arguably the most vital kill that changed that round, besides the opening frags that we see here, is Bisha falling to the hands of Snazy. And that's only because if Bisha had been able to retake that, that was a very vital position for Maverick to hold. And he would have been pinched in every way, shape, and form, and that round easily would have gone to RT. But Bisha, or not Bisha, Snazzy was just aware of Bisha's location, and I definitely agree. I think that's due to some fabulous drone work.
Yeah, you really do seem to think that we get first rounded are always in control of their intel at the very least. You know, they know what's going on. And if they fail to get the kill, it's simply because whoever on RT got the kill was simply a better shooter than them. The one exception to that, and I'm going to let the replays loop here just to show it, even though I do realize we're missing out on part of the preparation phase, is going to be the second kill that we saw, not the first one, but the second one. Jaeger, or Bandit, sorry, who was unbeknownst to Ash, basically in the middle of the room he was in, but who was not detected, and as such, he got a free kill on Firemeister. Gets the kill here, and that one right here. You know, he was not hidden in any way, shape, or form. He was just ready, and he exactly knew where his opponent was going to be. That was a refrag, basically.
Yeah, it was essentially a refrag, and I think what we get first rounded was expecting there was for Bant to be playing in kitchen like he was towards the very end of the round with Nitro Cell in hand, waiting to just go ahead and deny. They're a little more aware of that now, and there is a visual kind of roaming. Blue Bar is going to find the kills. That's going to be AIDS finding the first kill of the round once again onto another Ash. Cycle's going to fall. He's going to take some shots in the meanwhile as well from Firemeister. Far outside in Blue Bar, he's Firemeister going to find the kill onto Ness. Legion's out of play. His Goo Mines are going to be gone and extinct for the rest of this round. A very vital late round defense is now just going to be completely eliminated thanks to Firemeister's wonderful rappel up onto the window, or the game, the billiards window that we were talking about. We see another push here in the site as he is yokai'd and disoriented. The information is going to be there. He's not going to land a shot, so he's going to drop right through hatch. Hawk's going to get down by Bisha down in the service entrance kitchen area and is going to wind up falling. That's no more candelas left in hand. I don't think he got many off. However, there is a bit of sight control, but Defuse is going to fall back down in sight as Dash is going to find a kill onto Firemeister. Now a 2v4 situation. Things are suddenly not looking up for we get first rounded as there's four members left and plenty of utility to go through.
Yeah, absolutely. Even though the attackers still have lots of time to go with, you know, you can drone, you can relocate, you can think, generally speaking, at what your next move is going to be. You are still, you know, backs against the wall. Manpower, man advantage goes to RT, utility advantage goes to RT. Not much, you know, health pool maybe going to we get first round, but that's the only good news there is, you know. They're going to have to go for the face-to-face face check firefights, but that's not going to be easy since you have a yokai drone right here who will get destroyed, diffuser will be planted, so everything might be coming down to Gecko covering fire, and there the other yokai drone is gonna prove, you know, annoying. And that natural cell, even though you were on the bed, is not gonna be enough. Now a 1v2 situation. 58 seconds remaining on the clock. You do know that there's somebody at the bottom floor. No longer is the case though, but you know it would have been a 1v1 situation. Gets the first kill. We get the second one. He is going in, but Bisha is no longer in the objective already. He is already working on the flank, and I don't believe Gecko knows that.
If there still is a standard drone like they had last round, Bisha location may be known again, but the Claymore is going to be the thing that takes them out. Not looking down at your feet, Bisha. That's something you learn in Siege 101. Look at eye level, except when there's a Claymore, in which case you have.
You kind of have to do that, yeah. It was an unfortunate death because he... You know, the critical thinking was good. Like, he knew that Twitch was going to expect him to be on the bomb site itself. And as such, he knew not to be there, not to do the expected thing. But the unexpected yielded no result because he committed a beginner mistake. So, A+, you know, for creativity, for thinking. But, you know, D for actual execution. Next time is going to be the right time, though. Next time is going to work out. But in the meantime, we're going to be finding ourselves to a 5-1 scoreline. This is not looking good for RT, not one bit.
I would like to think that for right now, we get first rounded actually has a kind of a pocket strategy. I think they're going to force the hand of RT, or basically anyone who's going to be on the defending side first, by running gang and mass rushing. And then they're going to have something in their back pocket that no one's going to really think of, such as a Warden, like we see Gecko playing, we talked about earlier.
Indeed.
That's going to perfectly deny any sort of aggression coming from RT here.
Well, all five operators, to some extent, if you were, you know, to see them in a specific angle, could be considered, to some extent, counters to Ying. Let's just take Firemeister and Psycho out of the way first. They would be roamers, so you know, by not being on the bomb side, you shouldn't be the one exposed to the candela charges. Hawks is going to prevent Ying of just throwing the candelas through a doorway or through a window, which, you know, is going to make it so much harder to get the candelas in the bomb side. And then Snaze and Gecko, you know, they're pretty easy to figure out. So I'm not sure if this is the reasoning or the actual logic behind all of those operator picks, behind this exact composition. But definitely, it does seem like RT are gonna have a hard time playing Ying to as great of an effect as, you know, we first rounded did.
Gecko and Dash here kind of trading off a fair amount of health here. However, definitely not something you'd want to see from someone who could be a very vital sight hold come towards the plant denial phase. And Gecko is going to be possibly utilizing his ability here, unfortunately getting flashed by the first candela.
Floor?
Oh, that was through the floor. Wow.
I'm not sure what the reasoning was, though, because even though he found his opponents to be incapacitated, he had nothing to get the kills on, you know? Even though they were basically sitting ducks, he couldn't do anything about that. So I'm not sure exactly why that is. But there you go. Those ran out, yielded two kills for the defenders. A third kill with Ying trying to work on the intel. That's not going to work. Juan, last operator alive in a 1v4 situation. Would have been a 1v5, but a Claymore got a first kill. And you have somebody right here, left side. He gets a nice kill. Well, I did not know he was right there. But this time it's not going to work so easy because his position is now known. But what was I saying? Apparently nothing, because Gecko is also going to be biting the dust. No, a 2v1 situation. This is looking doable at this point, you know? A minute 20 remaining on the clock. A defender outside. Yeah, that's we get first rounded trolling at this point, to be honest.
They already know that they have the major advantage here with the defuse being so far outside and clearly in the line of sight of whoever it is outside. While Wanus One does have the advantage of knowing his exact location at all times, it just doesn't look like it's going to work out. Actually, scratch that. Once again, forget what any of the casters are saying, as Hawk's going to take a lot of damage here. Every turn, Juan's going to get a little bit of damage too, but with such a far range and using the UMP-45, there is not much hope to land any real critical shots besides potentially a headshot. But at that range, I wouldn't think so. His position may be known by some of Mozzie's pest captured drones.
The default cam actually was seeing him.
That was the default cam.
So, you know, even though they played well and that kind of stuff, you know, he still got three kills in a 1v5 situation. Two kills. Sorry, the Claymore got the first pick. He still committed a major mistake. You know, CD101 shooting default cams. So, all in all, I gotta say, RT are what I would say a somewhat strange team, because they do have team cohesion. They are playing well together. They do have strategies, all that good stuff. They definitely do know the game, you know. But then they are making easy mistakes, which I could not explain, because that's the kind of stuff you'd say, oh, he's a, you know, an amateur player. He's a beginner at the game. He doesn't know, you know, the basic. He's still learning. That's not the case for RT. They are displaying, you know, a good level, a consistent level of skill. But then they just forget about easy things like that. That's, you know, what I was going to say. That surprises me more than it should, I think.
I would hate to use such an unprofessional term, but I feel like there's no real other term for this other than just an absolute... After getting absolutely bamboozled the first six rounds, I wouldn't expect RT to pick up on, you know, default things as much. They'd be a little more on edge. They'd be a little more kind of worried about everything. And
yeah, look at that.
I feel like we get first round to definitely capitalize on that.
So that round is definitely going to be a troll round. No, a 6-1 scoreline. We get first rounded, are absolutely dominating everything. I didn't know you could send the yokai drone out during the preparation phase. I thought, you know, any and all defenders sided gadgets or utility throwables, whatever, are blocked inside the building for the first before, you know, the round starts. But apparently not. Apparently I was wrong, and that's just gonna be plain old sabotage and team kills and spawn kills. Okay. He's just gonna go at it, you know. Even though his position was known, he still wanted to get a kill. He was still insisting on that. Didn't work out too great, you know. And now the round is gonna be played at a 3-4 situation, which we get first rounded still might be coming back from. We've seen them display their skill. This is looking good for them, I gotta say.
Regardless of how much of a troll round this is, things definitely are still looking up in favor of we get first round, especially with who is still left on the board. May not be the most powerful weapons, but definitely able to hit their shots. With Dash going down, very unfortunately, to the hands of Gecko. That MPX all the way across the map is going to be a thing that finishes him off. And did Aids just shoot his own friendly drone, or was that one? That was not one of Mozzie's. He just shot his own drone.
Yeah. So the sabotage is apparently, you know, a common point between the two teams at this point. And that runout is not going to work, apparently not. Like, AIDS was swapping guns. He was reloading. I'm not exactly sure what he was doing. But he was definitely not ready to receive that pressure. And there you go. A nitro cell on the other end of the building. Firemaster with the MPX. And the MX Storm, rather. Sorry. And that's going to be the it for the game. We get first rounded. Really not breaking a sweat here.
I would like to say that RT put up a little bit more of a fight than the previous team did against RT, but I personally can't say that because I was not here for the first six rounds. Would you agree with that statement?
Sorry, say again?
The previous game, when RT was up against, I can't remember the exact name as I only came in really on the seventh round.
Fanboys.
Would you say that RT put up a better fight against We Get First Rounded than Fanboys did against RT in this?
I would say yes. Simply because fanboys kind of, you know, lost hope at some point. You know, they were losing players, they were team killing, and that was not a that was not a pretty sight to see. You know, the team just crumbling under presumably, you know, infighting. You know, and as such, RT, I cannot say that they tried 100% till the very last second, since, you know, Buck did destroy a teammate's drone, so that was presumably just, you know, let's take it easy, the game is over at this point. But still, they did not lose face, like, I hate to say it, because, you know, I don't want to be dissing the players, but fanboys really did not put up a good show.
Yeah, but hey. And I would have to say that the utmost dire kill of that round was Snazzy getting killed there. That was an absolute game changer and was exactly what brought We Get First Rounded to the victory. Being a 4v5 advantage already is going to be, or disadvantage is not going to mean anything for We Get First Rounded, apparently.